شهر فيه يوم أفضل من كل الأيام.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين أبي القاسم محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد، وعجل فرجهم وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المظلومين المنتجبين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الحكيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Today is the fifth of Ramadan al-Mubarak. Today we are going to talk about Ramadan, the month of purification. The ayah which I recited from Quran, Surah number 2, chapter number 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 183. Yes, it has become wajib on believers, but it's not a new thing. It was in the past communities, like the people of Musa, people of Hazrat Isa, and the other nation and the communities, they used to observe the fast in the different occasions. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made wajib on mu'min and believer in the month of Ramadan. But today our subject is month of purification of soul. What is the logic behind it? Why it is wajib? In one sentence, Quran said, one word, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So, you may be attain the piety. You could become a pious. What is piety? Why we will attend this? What the benefit is? Number one, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, accept the amal of the muttaqi. إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. In the Quran, who is the most honorable in the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? In Surah Al-Hujurat, He said, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The one who is powerful, the one who is wealthy, the one who has many friends, the one who is very eloquent, the one who is very rich, the one who is a scholar. No. إِنْ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. So, the path toward the piety, it is fasting in the month of Ramadan. Just I'm summarizing. In the Quran, in Surah Al-Jum'ah, verse number 2, when Quran talk about the duties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sent the Prophet, of course, Allah sent the Prophet, it is a great blessing for the world. Now you talk about هو الذي بعث في الأمين رسولا منه. He is Allah who sent the Prophet among the أمين, جاهل, ignorant. But the duties of Rasulullah, one is يتلو عليهم آياته, He recites the Quran, verses of the Quran. وَيُزَكِّهِمْ. But before He teach the Quran and Majid and the wisdom and guide the people, He purifies the soul of the people. So Allah would like to see the mu'min and believer in the month of Ramadan by fasting to purify himself, purify his body, purify his soul, purify his thought. Be positive. And you know that. Therefore, the aim behind is the obedience of Allah. Fast only for Him. As you know that, in Surah Al-An'am, ayah number 162, I recommend you to read before your prayer. Inshallah, you will be focused in your prayer. You will concentrate in your prayer. Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. Indeed, my prayer, my sacrifices, my life, my death, lillah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rabbil alameen, Lord of the universes. What the taqwa is, refrain from evil. While you're fasting from the Fajr time until the Maghrib time, halal thing become haram for you, and you stop yourself. While you are praying, you are not laughing, you are not talking, you are not smiling. Why? It is haram while you are praying. While you are going for Hajj, there are the 25 things, it become haram. It is the obedience. So learn from the fasting in the month of Ramadan. If something is haram for the certain period, which is actually halal, you made haram for you, and you are stopping yourself. Something which is haram, by like backbiting, lying, and all those things, refrain from it, because the aim is لعلكم تتقون. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.